Ladies and gentlemen, friends of universities, dear friends of innovation, first of all, allow me to start by warmly thanking the European University Association for the invitation to this event. It is a great pleasure, a honor for me to be here together with you to discuss the role of universities as a key component of the European innovation ecosystem. Indeed, it is absolutely crucial that higher education institutions are fully part of the innovation ecosystems across Europe. You are personifying the full knowledge triangle as education, research, and innovation are part of your activities. And I very much welcome the findings of your survey on innovation and European universities that includes the ideas, you said it, dear President, from 166 European universities from 28 European countries. Yes, actually we are working to create this pan-European innovation ecosystem, and I'm looking at you. You will participate in the discussion and you will share more details. But the outcomes of this survey will ensure that universities are fully on board in this endeavor. It is indeed important that universities become engines of regional innovation, of European leadership. And as the recovery offers the opportunity to invest in the future, it is now that we have collectively to build an environment in Europe in which innovation can thrive without leaving anyone behind. And it is encouraging to see that 53% of the respondents to your survey considered that their university pays high strategic attention to innovation, and that 78% of the surveyed universities are improving staff competence, student competence to innovate. But we need to go further. And in the context of the new wave of innovation, it is promising to see that 65% of the respondents collaborate with startups in a large or moderate extent. We need to continue moving in this new paradigm of innovation. And this new paradigm of innovation brings new challenges because the nature of innovation is changing and the global technological competition is intensifying. Together with stakeholders such as the Unicorns Group, Women in Venture Capital, or ecosystems leaders, we identified the main hurdles hampering Europe to become a leader in innovation. And for example, a lack of connections among local innovation ecosystems across Europe, or a business culture that is more risk averse and less conducive to innovation. To face these issues, we need higher education institutions to be key actors of change, to promote and lead innovation, to be part of the solutions for the future of Europe, and to create together with us this pan-European innovation ecosystem. This reinforced role of universities as engines for innovation will be reflected in the future innovation policy and also in the upcoming European strategy for universities. That's one of my demands today. Always look at those two documents at the same time in order this time really to not to talk only about synergies, but to transform this world into something operational, tangible, and beneficial for our universities and our innovators. So our vision is that the higher education institutions with this European strategy for universities will be interconnected, innovative, open, inclusive, and digital. They will foster the sustainable and competitive development of the society that we would like to see. And of course, we always have in mind the European Universities Alliances that were launched under Erasmus Plus. That's an excellent test bed of cooperation between universities, and many of them already have a very strong focus on innovation. For us, it will be really important to assure a follow-up of this initiative, but to see how we can work for all the universities, because I never forget that 41 alliances, that means 283 universities, and we have 5,000 in Europe. So allow me to turn now into maybe one concrete example of a university that I visited and where we can see that it's possible to work for this pan-European innovation ecosystem. That was the University of Salamanca in Spain. When I was there in September, I visited one of the largest startup festival organized in Europe, Startup Ole, And it was organized by a full professor and university students as volunteers. Right after, I visited one of the leading artificial intelligence labs, also in the tech park of the university. And from the AI lab, I walked to the library of the university, dating back from 1254, and hosting various priceless manuscripts and incunables. And this is a good example of a university that is becoming an engine for innovation, engaging professors, students, researchers, while at the same time keeping the richness of culture of the European universities. We have to preserve this. And this is not the only one example of universities becoming key actors in their local innovation ecosystem. We have the University from Finland organizing SLASH, or we have Delft University. And I stay at your disposal that the members of your associations are providing me example and to give them more visibility. I'm sure that we have a lot of other examples. What we need now is to promote the best practices, to see how we can provide them the right support in the right moment. And of course, count on me to give more visibility to what they are doing. And it's true that universities should not build innovation ecosystems that are isolated from the rest of the innovation ecosystem where they are located. Universities should become key actors that act as catalysts in their local and regional innovation ecosystems. But that's why we need to work together. Universities, investors, founders, entrepreneurs, as well as public administrations, to build this pan-European innovation ecosystem that will allow Europe to be a leader of the new wave of innovation, that will allow students from one university to find co-founders and investors from anywhere in Europe. And I think that we have all elements for making Europe the leader in this new wave of innovation around deep tech startups. This new wave of innovation has a hardware component in 84% of the cases. And in Europe, we have the leaders of industries with hardware component, from mechanical engineering to construction to energy to agriculture to automotive. And this new wave of innovation is based on intellectual property coming from science. And we are the leader in science in areas like energy or robotics or nanotechnology. On top of this, something that is, I think, close to our heart, the new wave of innovation is focused on solving the sustainable development goals. By supporting this new wave of innovation, by supporting the European universities as engine of this pan-European innovation ecosystem, we'll be solving our most pressing challenges, from climate change to health, to an economy that works for all, and reduces economic differences across Europe. Of course, we have, at this moment, not so much instruments for this support. And during the panel, I'm sure that Anna will provide you more details, but I'm thinking here about European Institute of Innovation and Technology and our Higher Education Innovate program. Of course, that's exactly what we would like to see how we can help those institutions where there is a need to build capacity to teach innovation, to have these entrepreneurial skills, and to develop especially concrete actions to increase their impact on the local ecosystem. The second I'm thinking too is the European Innovation Ecosystems component of Horizon Europe program. I would like here to see in a more concrete way how universities can be further supported in the next Horizon Europe program. So for me, for the moment, there is not so much concrete instruments that we have, but that's why it's our moment to see how first we can use the first important steps and tools that we have in our hands, and after to see where there is a need to intervene, to build something that is scalable, something that is more coherent, something that is more impactful. So to conclude, I would like to highlight that despite the impressive progress made so far, there is still a long way to go to ensure Europe becomes the global powerhouse for the innovation. And to do so, everyone must contribute to its full potential. And your recommendations are the vivid witness of the willingness of the stakeholders to boost innovation. And that's why, together with my team, we'll look very, very carefully in all the details of your study. To go further, just allow me to invite you to participate to the European Innovation Council Summit on the 24th and 25th of November. I'm not sure that there will be a strong voice of universities, and that's why I'm using this opportunity to invite you to be with us. I will be there for you too. So I think that at this occasion, we'll discuss exactly that, the future of innovation in Europe, and we'll launch the European Innovation Council Forum. And the forum will be a dedicated space to discuss and shape proposals for a future European innovation policy, to connect European innovation ecosystems and improve the existing instruments, not only the existing, and we have to do to have some new. So I hope really to see you there. I wish you a very fruitful conference. I will follow your conclusions very closely. Thank you very much, and again, count on my support. Thank you.